Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss about capacitive transducer. Capacitive transducer utilizes the capacitance variations of parallel plate capacitor to sense the change in physical quantity, that may be your pressure change, force change, displacement change or anything. Capacitive transducers are extensively used to measure linear and angular displacement, acceleration, velocity, force, pressure, liquid level, humidity, sound. Many capacitive transducers have wide applications. Capacitive transducer is a passive transducer. As capacitive transducer senses the physical quantity, that may be your pressure, force, weight, sound, anything. It converts the physical quantity into capacitance change. Then this change in capacitance is converted into electrical voltage or signal by connecting the capacitating transducer in a bridge or oscillator circuit. That's why it is a passive transducer, as it requires an external source of energy. Capacitive transducers are used in displays, mobile displays, condenser microphone, liquid level sensors, humidity sensors. So capacitive transducers have wide number of applications. Now let us discuss what is a capacitor. Capacitor consists of two parallel conducting plates separated by an insulating medium which is called as dielectric. The dielectric could be air, paper, ceramic, mica, polyester, polystyrene or polycarbonate plastic. So if the parallel plate capacitor consisting of two parallel plates having area A separated by distance D and having some dielectric material between them is connected to the opposite terminals of battery, then a charge Q is developed on the both plates of capacitor. Positive charge is developed on one plate of capacitor, negative charge is developed on another plate of capacitor. And due to this positive and negative charge, a potential difference is established across the two plates of capacitor. Now let us suppose if Q is the charge given to the plates of capacitor and it establishes a potential difference of V volt between the two plates of capacitor, then the capacitance of capacitor is given by C is equal to Q by V farad. So if Q equal to 1, V equal to 1, then capacitance is equal to 1 farad. 1 farad is defined as the capacitance of capacitor which require a charge of 1 coulomb to establish a potential difference of 1 volt between its plates. Capacitance of capacitor is also given by the formula C is equal to epsilon 0 epsilon R A divided by D. So where epsilon 0 is the permittivity of free space, which is equal to 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad per meter. Epsilon R is the permittivity of dielectric medium. A is the area of the plate and D is the distance between the plate. So epsilon 0 permittivity of free space is constant. Capacitance of capacitor is proportional to epsilon R, the permittivity of dielectric material, A overlapping area of the plates and inversely proportional to the distance between the plates. So capacitance can be changed by changing these three parameters. So first, capacitance can be changed by changing the overlapping area between the two plates, by changing the distance D between the two plates, or by changing the dielectric material in between the two plates. The capacitive transducer consists of two parallel conducting plates, out of which one plate is fixed, that is static plate, and another plate is movable, that is diaphragm, which and both the plates are separated by a dielectric. Usually it is air, but another dielectric can be there. The diaphragm can be made up from variety of materials, glass, plastic, silicone, ceramic, to suit different applications. The stiffness and strength of diaphragm material can be chosen to provide a range of sensitivities and operating pressures. To get a large signal, the diaphragm should be large, but it will limit the frequency response. On the other hand, smaller diaphragms are more sensitive and have a faster frequency response. If you have a large thin diaphragm, then it can be sensitive to even noise from vibrations. So this large thin diaphragm are used in condenser microphones. Then thicker diaphragms are used for high pressure sensors and to ensure mechanical strength. As the diaphragm is itself sensing element, there are no other components which are bonded to the diaphragm. So capacitive transducer can work at higher temperature than other types of transducers. Capacitive transducer can be directly constructed on a silicon chip with the same manufacturing techniques that are used in the manufacturing of semiconductor electronic devices. So these allows very small size capacitive transducer to be constructed, which can be used with other electronics in signal conditioning and reporting. Working of capacitive transducer. So when pressure is applied to the movable plate, and if the pressure increases, then the movable plate diaphragm moves inward. And we know that the capacitance of capacitive transducer is inversely proportional to the distance. So as the distance between the static plate and diaphragm decreases, capacitance increases, means capacitance changes. Now if the pressure is released or pressure is decreased, then diaphragm moves outward, the distance between the plates increases and capacitance decreases. So this change in capacitance can be measured by connecting the capacitive transducer to an oscillator circuit or a bridge circuit, and it can be converted into an electrical voltage and signal. Now let us discuss condenser microphone. So condenser microphone is nothing but a capacitor microphone, because condenser is the old term which is used for capacitor. Condenser microphone or capacitor microphone is a capacitive transducer which converts sound into electrical signal. You may have encountered condenser microphones in the studio, or you may have used it while recording. So you may have seen condenser mics in your day-to-day life. So what does this condenser microphone consist of? So condenser microphone consists of two parallel conducting plate. One plate, which is back plate, which is made up of brass, and second plate is a movable plate diaphragm, which is made up of ultra thin metal foil or a gold coated plastic film. So the whole assembly is enclosed in a condenser capsule. You can see it plainly entirely if you remove the microphone grill from most of the condenser microphone. Now when sound wave strikes the diaphragm, the distance between the diaphragm and back plate changes, and because of which the capacitance changes, and because of this the voltage across the capacitance changes. The voltage variations of the capacitor are in step with the pressure variations of the incident sound. Voltage variations across the plates of capacitor produces no current almost at all. So to the sound signal to be recorded, this voltage needs to be amplified. So a capacitor microphone require an external power source to amplify the signal. Now how this can be achieved? So this can be achieved by supplying a 48 volt phantom power to the capacitor microphone. So this can be done by using a preamplifier or by sending the 48 volt phantom power through a coaxial cable which is attached to the condenser microphone. Now why it is called as phantom power? Because the coaxial cable which is carrying the audio signal, or which is carrying the signal, is also transforming the power. So that's why it is called as phantom power. Another way of supplying power to the condenser microphone is by using an electrode. So electrode is a permanently charged dielectric ferroelectric material which, once charged during its manufacture, holds its charge infinitely, thereby eliminating the need for polarizing voltage source. So the electrode microphone is similar to the condenser microphone, except that condenser microphone needs a polarizing voltage source, but electrode microphone does not need a polarizing voltage source because it has an electrode that is permanently charged material. This electrode material is either coated as a ultra thin film on the back plate or on the diaphragm. So this condenser microphone uses an electrode material. You can find electrode microphones in your portable devices, laptop, mobile, computers. Many recording applications uses electrode microphone. Electric gauge. We know that the capacitance of capacitor changes if the dielectric material between the two plates of capacitor is changed. So this principle is used in dielectric gauge. Dielectric gauges are used to measure liquid levels, then humidity sensors. They have vast number of applications. So let us see this dielectric gauge. So dielectric gauge or liquid level sensor simply consists of two electrodes. So first electrode forms one plate of parallel plate capacitor which is dipped in the liquid. Another electrode can be the outer wall of the tank if the tank is made up of metallic material, or it can be a reference electrode if it is a non-metal tank. Then in between this there is a liquid. So if no liquid is there, air is there, capacitance will be different. With the liquid, capacitance will be different. So it can give you the level of liquid. The dielectric gauge can be used to measure non-conductive material as well as conductive material. For non-conductive material, bare probe arrangement can be used. The electrode is not insulated because the liquid resistance is high enough so that it can act as a dielectric. Now, the distance between the electrode and tank wall is fixed. So, only the dielectric, that is the liquid, that is changing. So, the capacitance is directly proportional to the level of the liquid. For conductive liquid, the electrode is coated using thin coating of glass or plastic so that to avoid short circuit, the material act as the ground plate of the capacitor. Advantages of capacitive transducer. Capacitive transducers are inexpensive and easy to construct. They have low power consumption. They have high frequency response, high sensitivity, high resolution, smaller in size, lighter in weight, so can be used in number of applications, high output impedance. Capacitive transducer has number of applications, but to list a few, capacitive transducers are used as humidity and moisture sensors. They are used in microphones, liquid level sensor, measure to break disc deformation, measurement of linear and angular displacement, capacitive displacement sensors, dynamic measurements at turbines and engine, thickness measurements,